Hi there, YouTube. It's Mark here again. Today's video is going to be basically just an update on some of the things I've been picking up over the last few weeks. Most of what I'm going to show you is actually new pressings of older recordings. I do have some used stuff as well that I picked up at the local record shop and online. So first off, I'm going to start off with what you hear in the background there. It's Muddy Waters. I'm Ready. And this is a 1978 pressing, produced by Johnny Winter. And Johnny Winter does a lot of guitar work on this album as well. This was a trio of albums, or the middle one of a trio of albums recorded by Muddy Waters in the late 70s. Really cool stuff on here. What you hear there is Hoochie Coochie Man and great songs in here. I'm Ready, Mamie, Rock Me, Screaming and Crying, Good Morning Little Schoolgirl. Some great stuff. Cool drawings of Muddy on the cover as well. New reissue of T-Rex's Tanks album. I've always had the Slider and Electric Warrior, but I've never owned a copy of this one. I just purchased this the other day. It's a very cool album. Songs are pretty much as good as the ones on the previous two albums I mentioned. Great album, T-Rex. When I was 13 years old, 1973, I saw the live broadcast of Elvis Aloha from Hawaii. Never forgot it. My mom was a huge Elvis fan at that time. And I'll never forget all the screaming women and Elvis with his white towel wiping his brow and tossing it into the crowd and these women just fighting for his towel. It was a very good performance by Elvis as well. I started to pack on a little bit of the weight there, but that performance was pretty electrifying and was the first worldwide concert, or it's actually it's the most watched or viewed worldwide concert by any entertainer via satellite that year in 1973. Just rounding off my Frank Zappa collection, I finally scored a copy of Mother Mania, The Best of the Mothers. On Verve Records. This one's a UK press. Not an original press, I think it's the second press of this album. It's Verve Select. Whenever you see the word select, it's usually a repress, not an original. Went into the record store and 45 minutes away from here. Brand new copy of John Coltrane's Blue Train. I haven't purchased any jazz albums up until now. This is my first venture into it. I know a lot of you guys on the vinyl community have mentioned this album in the past, and John Coltrane in particular. He's an artist's name that's floating around all over the place. So I thought I'd buy it. Very cool record. It comes with a CD as well of the album. So driving home, I thought, you know what? I got the CD right here. I'll put it in the car and start listening to it. And at first, I thought, I don't know if I'm going to like this or not. I was listening to it, but then again, you have the distractions of the traffic and all that stuff, and I was thinking to myself, I don't know, maybe I shouldn't have bought this album. But once I got it home, put it on my turntable, get rid of all the distractions, I actually really started getting into it, and I played it now about 3 times, and each time I play it, I like it more, so I'm not sure if I'm going to go big into the jazz area or not, but I did really enjoy it, and again, I love albums that grow on you. You listen to it, and you like it more every time you listen to it. So I'll be looking forward to the next time I play this record. John Coltrane, Blue Train. Maybe. On the jazz vein, I thought because I enjoyed that album, I picked up another one that's big name in the jazz field. They say it's probably the best-selling album ever. In the jazz genre, Miles Davis, Kind of Blue. Not disappointed in the music because I haven't been able to play it. And the reason is, what I am disappointed in is the record. I'm gonna have to try to send it back. It's got a severe warp in it. 180 gram vinyl. I've never seen that in a heavy record with such a extreme warp. But going to see what I can do to get an exchange on this one, because I'm really looking forward to listening to it. Okay, the bulk of my updates is going to be Jimi Hendrix. Most of his works and all his works done after he passed away, the collections that came out, have been reissued or just issued on 180 gram vinyl. I've already shown this one on the past video, but I just wanted to show it again. What's really cool about this is it's a two record set as opposed to the original one album, and the reason for it is that it has both the songs from the American version and the UK version, which were, most of the songs were in common, but the UK version had some songs the American version didn't have, and vice versa, but all the songs are on this album here. Most of the Hendrix reissues also come with a beautiful 8-page color booklet inside the record, which really adds to the aesthetics of it and the visual aspect of listening to the music. And also the sound qualities of these repressings are amazing as well. So I've had this one for a while, but I just wanted to show it again. Brand new, just got it. It's a very recent reissue. It's Hendrix in the West, a collection of live recordings. I used to own the single album. Actually, it was the only Hendrix album I ever owned. When I was in my teens and my 20s, I never really had gotten into Hendrix. I'm just starting to now, actually. What's cool about this is, again, it comes with, I'm going to show you the booklet. I'm not sure if the original was a gatefold. I don't think it was. But there's a gatefold picture inside there. And it comes with the two albums. Plus, as I mentioned, color booklet as well. So each of these repressings is really cool because it kind of tells a story about the how the album came about, and it talks about any of the additional tracks that have been put in and just what was going on with Hendrix at the time. Really, really cool pictures. I don't know if that's good too. My camera's picking that up or not, but so really happy to get this. And if you're looking for a copy of this, I'm going to suggest a website that I purchased most of these records on, because the prices are very, very reasonable, and also shipping and handling charges are extremely reasonable. To ship this to Canada, I think it costs around $6. So, and this online at this website, oldies.com, only costs $15, which is an amazing price for a two record 180 gram set. Electric Ladyland. Again, I purchased this album from the same website, and this retailed for $16.97 at oldies.com. Another great price for a fantastic album. Again, two records, gatefold, all kind of black and white pictures all around the upside of the gatefold here. Very cool color booklet and clothes. One of the greatest pictures of Hendrix, I think, is this really colorful picture here. And again, it's got the 8-page booklet with the story behind the album and loads of photographs. Really cool stuff. Keeping up with the Hendrix vein. What started all this off with the Hendrix? It was a video, I think it was Robin Boston, who was grooving to this record here, Jimi Hendrix Valley of Neptune, and that's what kind of spurred my interest in it, because I really haven't collected much of Hendrix in the past, and Rob was really getting into this, and so I thought I'd punch it up, and this too is on that same website too. So oldies.com has a great selection of Hendrix albums. I think this was only $17 as well, and two record set. Again, great gatefold picture, and it also comes with the 8-page booklet, which I'm not going to bother to show that one, but you kind of get the idea. Haven't had a chance to listen to this yet. Read some reviews on it, and it's got some pretty favorable reviews, and know, some versions of some of his greater songs like Red House, Lover Man, Stone Free, and of course Bellies of Neptune. So very happy to have that. More Hendrix. Axis Bold is Love. Again from the same website. This is basically just a duplicate or a carbon copy of the original album. It's a single album, but it does come with the 8-page booklet again. And gatefold cover, which all you Hendrix fans are familiar with. The front and the inside. And to be honest, I haven't had a chance to listen to this either, but I get some time to do it. But really happy to get that. And the first one they purchased after the Are You Experienced album, which I bought a while back, was Jimi Hendrix Live at Woodstock. And this one's a 3-album set. And of course it has the Star Spangled Banner and Purple Haze, the same that was on the Woodstock album. Then again, it's got loads of stuff on here that was never included on that album, like Fire, Voodoo Child, Slight Return, Spanish, Castle Magic, Red House, Lover Man, Hear My Train A-Comin'. You know, the sound quality back in that time, or at that venue in particular, was not the best. But nevertheless, it's still, you know, a very important album for Hendrix collectors. Very cool packaging as well. It's a tri-fold album cover. Very cool, and it comes with the booklet as well. So this one is rapidly becoming one of my favorite records. I've listened to it now a couple times, and I just think it's a great album. That's basically it for Hendrix. Some other ones I picked up: a mint copy of Paul Simon's debut album. And I think it is a first press. The cover is just pristine, so is the vinyl. It's got the old Columbia label. Again, I'm not certain if it's a first press or not. It has the rigid inner sleeve too. And it's got the old red Columbia label. Played this a few times now already too, and I just love Paul Simon. Some of these songs are on his Greatest Hits, which is an album I've owned for quite a long time, but then there's a lot of songs in here I've never heard before because I never owned the album, and it's just great stuff. I don't think Paul Simon ever wrote a bad tune. It's just great music. And the last album I'd like to show you is I've always been a Pink Floyd fan. Very hard to track down the albums Piper at the Gates of Dawn and Saucer Full of Secrets, especially in decent condition. And if you do find them, they're usually very, very expensive. So I settled for a copy of Pink Floyd's A Nice Pair, which is basically those two albums. And this album was released shortly after Dark Side of the Moon, and the record company was basically just trying to capitalize on Pink Floyd's success with that album, so they reissued two of their earlier albums in one package like this. This is a UK pressing too. Awesome album, great condition. The cover, I was a little bit disappointed during shipping. You know, I like to receive albums where the albums are actually outside the cover, because if they put the albums in the gatefold and ship it, oftentimes this is what happens. The camera probably isn't going to pick that up, but I got double splits across the top of the record, and it was a little disheartening to see that. I actually sent a suggestion to the seller, and you know, for future sales, whether he's going to follow my suggestion or not remains to be seen. But I didn't leave him negative feedback. Like, he described the album very well, but I was just a little upset to see that on the top there. Anyway, really happy to have this. It kind of rounds out my Pink Floyd collection. So that's it for my update. Probably the biggest update I've had in a while. Hope you enjoyed my video, and please leave comments.